Like an early morning start today, like a cold winter breeze blowing, but I'm sure that's gonna it's gonna switch direction a little bit later, and might warm up a little bit because it is really chilly.
Hello. Okay. You miss your food more of my up, hear me?
Okay.
It's the father.
Oh, good morning, guys. Yeah, I'm just laughing because Gerhard Groenewald from Battle My Charges is here with me, and I was just about to record and say hello to you guys, and then I heard him shouting and it is on, and then it was a seagull that flew into his line, so he almost had a little bit of a struggle with the seagull. Luckily it came untangled and it flew off. The sea is really, really flat. I don't have too much high hopes for today, but we're going to see if we can't catch a galjoen, maybe, if you're lucky. Sometimes in this flat sea you can get some really big galjoen. We are fishing some deep water spots with some big pinnacles on the outside and some islands, so we will find some working water, and hopefully we can catch a red Roman or a yellow belly or just something to show you guys. But I'm amped. It's been a while since I've been next to the water, but it's really lucky to be here, and we've got some really frot red bait, guys. Yeah. Anyway, let's make the throw. Let's get some frotters. We've got a selection of frot red bait today. Frot, very frot, and murtu frot. Which one are we going with? Let's have a look at this one. Whew. That's the one. That's the one. Like a sand red bait, like a frot. There we go. Like a sand arsi. Inside out. 2-0 circle hook. Bob's your anchor. Let's gooi. I shall call you must bite. Cold ass.
Oh.
Romanky. What's that? Yeah, but it's a monster. What is it? Monster! Oh, this is mooi.
I said no, but
call you on the fuck again. Oh, you didn't call you me?
Like you did.
Like I didn't
know. Yeah, the call you.
Is that called you?
Yeah,
that called you.
There's the first galley of the morning. Lekker, well done, Gerhard.
Nice.
Vang nog een. My first little galley for the morning. Just a tiny one, but at least there's some action and there's been bites in every straw. Whether it's a small red Roman, a blacktail or small galleon, there's some action, so you just need to find the right size of fish and then get that circle look. Okay, right down there. Look at that circle look, perfectly in the corner, doing its job. Gerhard is another blacktail. Filling up a whole pool here with fish. I'm just gonna put the galjoen in the pool and then we'll release them a little bit later. Not to scare off the rest of the shoal. See, the fish are shy to eat, or the galjoen, they feed really shy. I think it's because the water is so clean and flat that they just hug the structure really close. You just feel them pushing you, pulling, and then eventually it's on. But yeah, it's just lucky to be out here again, eh? It's not that cold anymore, really lucky. So we're just busy putting the galjoen back that we caught, and then we're going to move to the next spot. But I think they're fine with the pushing tide, they will go out, but Gerhard wants to make sure. Number two, and one more. Blacktail, we can leave. I think the third one is out already. Oh.
of it. You want to go in? Right.
Okay, so we fish on this spot for a couple of throws, and looked really nice when we got here. Well, not really nice, but didn't look too bad when we got here, but it's starting to clean up a lot. The constant foam is going away. Gerhard got that okay sized red Roman, and that was basically it. Besides one or two blacktail bites. Time for a little break and a snack. Yeah, my furniture is off. Snack time is over, we need to go and find a spot now, catch a fish. Just got a really nice red Roman. I don't know what I filmed on this camera because my chest cam died. So I just want to get this fish to a pool and put this camera down and then show you the fish. I really didn't think it was such a good red Roman because it had a terrible bite on it. I knew it was a red Roman, but I thought it was like a 30 centimeter fish, but we're gonna measure it now as well. Okay, just get it in that pool quickly. Okay. Okay. Before I show you guys the fish, I just want to do a quick measurement. Fork length into the V of the tail is 40 centimeters, 400 millimeters, and then total 43.5. So 43.5 centimeters fork length, ach, total length, and what did I say, 40 into the V, but it doesn't matter. Really good fish, good condition, beautiful colors on it, and yeah, for a little, trying to get my rod layer properly. I'm using the 14 foot horizon because it's got a little bit of a faster action. It has that pulling power to pull the fish out of the rocks and out of the structure. That's why I prefer the 14 foot AV 4 to 6 ounce. It goes a long way to get to the reef and to the spots where these fish hold. But you know, I just want to show the fish to you guys. There we go. Beautiful red Roman. stunning colors. I love the colors on the head. It's like a turquoise blue line there on the nose. Just check it out, guys. Look at that fish. That's a little bit of in the camera. It's not as big as it looks now because I'm holding it forward, but a little bit more in perspective. There you guys can see stunning fish, reef fish. Just want to keep it in the water. I don't want to keep it out of the water too long because I'm going to safely release this fish. Because they're really slow growing. They're territorial and residential in their areas, so I don't like to kill them. Look at that hump on the fish. A really nice hump. And that shows you that it is a good quality fish. Senior citizen of the reef. I'm just admiring its colors here on the GoPro. And it's truly amazing. But that's enough admiring for one day. So let's get this beauty back. I'll give you guys one more look. Oh, beautiful. Going back. Okay. See if we can't get another fish. Maybe one more Roman, a yellow belly, or anything. I'll fish for a galjoen a little bit later again, but while the tide is still low enough to get them to these spots where it's deep water and you can reach those further out reefs and the deeper water, let's fish for the red Roman. You can always find a spot for a galjoen a little bit later. Yes, they're biting really bad. Not the best bite in the world today. There they are. Yeah, it doesn't feel like a bad one. Alright, come on, over the reef. So foul this belly spot. That's it. Of us. Oh man. Another goodie. Let's give it some air time. Okay, let's measure this one. Let's see if this one out. Get some water here in the rock so that it's nice and wet. I'm gonna get this camera down so that you guys can see what I'm up to here. Just gonna make it all wet. And then a little measure. That looks like a similar size fish than the previous one. This one measures. Okay, on the fork. Let's get it nice and flat. Yeah. Also about 40 on the fork length. And then, yeah, 43. So yeah, this fish is like exactly the same length as the previous one. And what I want to show you guys is I've got quite big, let me just get my put in here, they got quite big mouths and they're quite aggressive feeding fish, and that's why I'm using a circle hook and a fiver circle hook. That is, I don't want to go too small. Look at that mouth. Even if you use like a 3040 circle hook or 2030 circle hook, the possibility, I just want to get the fish in the pool while I talk to you guys, the possibility of getting the hook down the throat and still gut hook it, especially if you want to release it, it's still there. So that's why I use a slightly bigger circle hook, like a 5-0. You can even go a 6-0 if you want to. But to me, the 5-0 BKK inline is the optimal size hook for targeting a red Roman. You might miss one or two smaller ones in between, but it doesn't matter. You want to catch the bigger fish, but you'll catch a really small one of like 25 to 30 centimeter on a 5-0 hook as well, because they really, really like, they just shove everything down their throat. Circle hooks really important for easy release. So just a turn of a hook and press. Don't let this thing bite you because it has a nasty jaw on it, really strong jaws, ripping off muscles and crunching open red bait and grabbing onto prey. They even feed on smaller fish. They're quite enjoyable species to catch on artificials as well when you're targeting them on the boat. When using small slow pitch jigs and paddle tails, jerk baits, and soft plastics, all kind of things, they eat it. Okay, time to go back, bad boy. Catch him next time. Sure, just as I released that red Roman, a whole pod of dolphins came past. So I hope you guys can see it on the GoPro. And this is where I need my drone. Ooh. But it's not fixed yet. I broke it in the Richtersveld. But yeah, let's see if you guys can see it. Yeah, really amazing animals. They're really close. Like they're swimming underneath Gerhard's line. Bonsai. Well, we've covered some ground today, but yeah, there's no galjoen. We just caught a whole bunch of small galjoen and blacktail and all sorts of nonsense. But it's snack time again, and then we move. Okay, shot guys. I think we had enough for one day. Tough conditions, sea was really flat, really clean, and it wasn't too easy to get any fish. At least we got some fish, we managed some fish. While I was filming one of the red Romans that I caught, Gerhard caught a small mussel cracker, an undersized one of about, I don't know, 40 to 45 centimeters. didn't get any footage of it, and threw it back. But a lot of small fish, a lot of undersized fish, a lot of small galjoen. And at least it was a fun day out, and then it's always awesome to be next to the water and just appreciate the nature and the beauty of the ocean. And then just to remind you guys, another way to support Zuluk fishing is to support Stefan at Still Fishing. That's the tackle shop where I purchase all my fishing gear and tackle. If you've been with the channel for some while, you will have seen Stefan in the past, and I'm sure you're going to see him in the future again. I want to put my rod down here. They've got a great online store running with great prices and excellent service. If you want to make use of their online shop, the link will be down in the description. If you go directly onto the online shop and you want to support Zuluk fishing in the process, just add my referral code, which is ZLF, in the referral box. A little bit of that goes towards my channel and helps fund this channel and helps me to create these videos for you guys. So we're getting really close to the summer. Can't wait to put my hands on a big silver slab cob. There might be some awesome stuff in the near future that I'm going to do, some light tackle estuary fishing and all sorts of things. But yeah, if you want to see all this and you don't want to miss out, hit the subscribe button, put on your notification bell so you'll be notified once I upload a new video. Cheers guys, see you next week.